who is the least liked Justice League of Justice League of all? We were looking at Aquaman today.
Oh my
God. So this is Aquaman, 80 Years of the King of the Seven Seas. This is a hardcover by DC. Let me show you the front. Here you go. The spine and the back. And this is this an oversized? Let's take a look. Let me grab an Omni just so we can see. Let's do a DC Omni. So it looks like it is Omni format, so that's great. Or so it is an oversized.
Yeah. OAC, oversized hardcover.
Yep. Very cool. Let's go look underneath. So 80 years of Aquaman. Man, that's crazy. You know, Aquaman is one of those OG superheroes, you know, along with the, you know, Batman, Superman. So that's crazy. 80 years.
It's been 80 years and he only has one omnibus? Dang, man. I love that.
Call, ask DC, hey, can you please just not reprint one Batman Omni so we can do enough? No! Just Batman! All right, so this includes iconic stories selected from 8 decades of high seas adventures starring Aquaman, Mera, Aqualad, Vulko, Ocean Master, Black Manta, and the Trench. And it features over 400 pages of classic and modern tales, such as Aquaman Joins the Navy, The Kid from Atlantis, Between Two Dooms, A Quiet Day in Atlantis, A Crash of Cymbals, and more. So you get a collection of stories on some of the formats, as you can see here. You definitely have like some of that white because this is just the format I was before. Numbered at the bottom. Pages feel good. They're not too thin, which is great. And there you go. Actually, I think he is definitely a underrated character. He's almost as strong as Superman. Plus, he can, you know, underwater, he's almost unbeatable. And, you know, he has a hot redhead. Bro. I really like the Whenever the New 52 Jim Lee's Aquaman. That one was really fun. I really enjoyed that story. If you haven't read that one, I highly recommend it. It's really good. It really puts Aquaman in a different light. Kind of gives, you know, it shines a light on his backstory a lot more in the New 52. And I thought that one was a really good story. And it actually shows a little bit of it here. I'll get to it. But it kind of shows you as we go through the decades. This is definitely like the 90s style Aquaman when he had that, when he got the hook. And early 2000s, he has that like metal arm. They tried to do that redesign. It's all right. I mean, it's not my favorite. I definitely like the New 52 costume for him at least. It's very classic, I would say. Let me see. Yeah, basically the yellow with the green. Very cool. And let's keep going. Did I pass it already? No, it's still back. I'm still behind it. Do you think Aquaman looks... Here we go. Better with a beard or without the beard, JP? Do you think he looks cooler with the beard?
Jason Momoa looked pretty cool with the beard.
Yeah, he did.
Aquaman.
Yeah, he did. You have Aquaman with long hair or beard, or Aquaman... who shaves in the ocean and it looks like this. I kind of feel like the beard.
Menacing.
I like the beard because it kind of sets him apart from like the rest of like Superman and you know.
That's true.
Yeah.
Like, how do you shave underwater?
This is a good story, guys. If you haven't read it, The Trench, such a good story. Seriously. Yeah, there we go. Geoff Johns, there we go. I said Jim Lee, I apologize. Geoff Johns wrote this one and it was great. I really, really like that story for Aquaman. And then I believe we have some even more modern ones, which are these, which I haven't read, so I feel sorry for myself. But if you have, there you go. See? Now you got the best of it. The costume with the classic costume with the long hair and the beard. Nice. All right. So there we go. So that is the Aquaman 80 Years of the King of the Seas, guys. If you're an Aquaman fan, get it. If you're not, then, you know, get it and still you like it. And get Organic Press Books, and I will see you guys in the next one.